thank you, Mr. Todd, for that presentation. Next, we'll have the Lindens Program activities for fiscal year 2007, Director Dorsey.
Thank you, Madam Chairwoman. My name is Rex Dorsey. I am a loan officer with the lending department at the Regional Commission. And each year we have the opportunity to present to you our annual report, which kind of gives you an idea of what our programs have been doing the last fiscal year, to show you kind of the economic impact we're having in our region and in our communities. A very brief history of our programs. Programs that we offer, we've been in the commercial lending business since 1979. We operate a $6 million revolving loan fund that's made up of funds that were grants and as well as loans from the EDA and rural development. And through those years, we have received several and operate those funds in what we refer to as our in-house. Money we use, we participate with banks, and we use it typically for fixed assets, long-term financing. In addition to that, we are a certified development company licensed by the Small Business Administration to make SBA 504 loans. In those types of loans, SBA actually participates with the bank in putting up to 40% of the loan. Also, and those are fixed assets, long-term financing, maybe fixed rate, it's typically one of those banks. And thirdly, we are a lender service provider working with multiple banks in our region and outside, which we package SBA 7A loan guarantees. In that situation, the bank actually makes the entire loan, and SBA gives a guarantee up to about 85% of it. Our role is that we package the application for them, submit it to SBA on the bank's behalf, which is serving as a package in that capacity. All of our loans, as we said, in any of either of the programs, we do participate with a private lender, and borrower rejection is typically required. We like to call that, or refer to it as private leverage. If you look in the package we've got, this year our private leverage was 1.45 to 1, which means that for every $1 we lent, there's $1.45 of private funds that were also involved in the project. Let's take a look at the numbers from this past year. If you'll take a look at the packet that you've got for the first page gives you a summary of our loan activity this year. We actually did 18 loans, total project investment into a little over $9.5 million. The Regional Commission's portion of those loans was a little over $3.5 million. So 189 jobs were created in those capacities. Just below there, you'll see the breakout of those 18 loans and which types of programs we did. There were five SBA 504 loans. We packaged seven 7A loans for banks. And we actually did six loans out of our in-house revolving loans. The next section there you'll see is a breakdown of the banks that we participated with this past year. They're in kind of a ranking order of total project investment. And you can see the number of loans that we did with each bank there as well. The bottom section breaks down the projects in which counties the loan took place. Those are also ranked by the total project investment as well. The back side is, again, a recap of our loan programs to give you more detail if you are interested in what purposes they serve. And you'll see a list of our current 2017 loan board of directors as well. The next page, just moving quickly through, is more of a detailed breakdown of the loans that took place this past fiscal year. We broke them out into the loans that actually funded and closed, And then there were others that were approved that are not quite closed or funded just yet. You can also see the type of program the loan took place in, as well as the type of business. So you can see the various industries we did participate with this year, as well as the bank that participated in the county. It's a good way to see the total project where all the activities are taking place. The next page is a cumulative detailed report of the loan program since inception in 79. See a breakdown of how many loans we've done and the types of the loan programs that are listed there. So since 79, you can see that we have done almost $285 million in total project investments and created a little over 10,031 jobs. And the bottom is just a breakdown of the funds we received from EDA and World Development that makes up the revolving loan fund. So you can see it's a little over $5 million. And the very last back page is a list of our current board directors with their contact information, employment, and which membership group they contribute to our board. And as we do every year, we're required to have the council reappoint the board for the next fiscal year. So we would like to ask to do that. Oh, sure. Yes, our board is made up of, if you can see, there's a little blur at the bottom that discusses where the criteria, I guess, of our board members. And our board is a blend of, for our Certified Development Corporation, which is our SBA 504 loans, and our Area Resource Development Agency, which is our revolving loan fund. We blend them into one because it's just easier. So the criteria is kind of a mix. You can't have more than 50% bankers. So we try to keep it pretty close to that 50%, having lenders with that experience on board. The others, you can see this middle category is a membership group. We have to have representatives from corporate governance and community and workforce development, internal controls. So we have CPAs, we have some attorneys, we have community members, like officials, a handful. So it's quite a vast array. And we try to spread them out, of course, throughout the region. We can't have representatives from every county, but we do try to spread the expertise in the territory as well.
If you need a few days to read over the reappointment of the bank members, if not, I'd like to have a motion. Please second.
Second.
I have a motion and second, and I'll begin the discussion. All in favor?
Aye.